Living well and doing right require perseverance and spiritual direction.
Our Daily Bread.
Today's encouragement from the Our Daily Bread devotional is written by Amy Boucher Pye. Cowboy builders is a term many British homeowners use for tradespeople who do shoddy construction work. The term is bandied about with fear or regret, often because of bad experiences. No doubt there were rogue carpenters, masons, and stonecutters in biblical times. But tucked away in the story of King Joash in 2 Kings 12:15, repairing the temple, is a line about the complete honesty of those who oversaw and did the work. However, King Joash did what was right in the eyes of the Lord only when Jehoiada the priest instructed him. As we see in 2 Chronicles 24, 17-27, after Jehoiada died, Joash turned from the Lord and was persuaded to worship other gods. The mixed legacy of a king who enjoyed a season of fruitfulness only while under the spiritual counsel of a godly priest makes us stop and think, what will our legacies be? Will we continue to grow and develop in our faith throughout our lives, producing good fruit? Or will we become distracted by the things of this world and turn to modern-day idols such as comfort, materialism, and self-promotion?
Today's Our Daily Bread devotional scripture reading is from 2 Kings chapter 12, verses 1 through 15. In the seventh year of Jehu, Joash became king, and he reigned in Jerusalem 40 years. His mother's name was Zibiah. She was from Beersheba. Joash did what was right in the eyes of the Lord all the years Jehoiada the priest instructed him. The high places, however, were not removed. The people continued to offer sacrifices and burn incense there. Joash said to the priest, "Collect all the money that is brought as sacred offerings to the temple of the Lord, the money collected in the census, the money received from personal vows, and the money brought voluntarily to the temple. Let every priest receive the money from one of the treasurers, then use it to repair whatever damage is found in the temple." But by the 23rd year of King Joash, the priests still had not repaired the temple. Therefore, King Joash summoned Jehoiada the priest and the other priests and asked them, "Why aren't you repairing the damage done to the temple? Take no more money from your treasurers, but hand it over for repairing the temple." The priests agreed that they would not collect any more money from the people and that they would not repair the temple themselves. Jehoiada the priest took a chest and bored a hole in its lid. He placed it beside the altar on the right side as one enters the temple of the Lord. The priests who guarded the entrance put into the chest all the money that was brought to the temple of the Lord. Whenever they saw that there was a large amount of money in the chest, the royal secretary and the high priest came, counted the money that had been brought into the temple of the Lord, and put it into bags. When the amount had been determined, they gave the money to the men appointed to supervise the work on the temple. With it, they paid those who worked on the temple of the Lord, the carpenters and builders, the masons and stone cutters. They purchased timber and blocks of dressed stone for the repair of the temple of the Lord and met all the other expenses of restoring the temple. The money brought into the temple was not spent for making silver basins, wick trimmers, sprinkling bowls, trumpets, or any other articles of gold or silver for the temple of the Lord. It was paid to the workers who used it to repair the temple. They did not require an accounting from those to whom they gave the money to pay the workers, because they acted with complete honesty. That was today's scripture reading from 2 Kings chapter 12, verses 1 through 15.
And now let's pray together. Father God, we pray that our legacies will be good fruit that was produced from lives of faith in and commitment to you. May we be diligent in keeping our eyes and hearts fixed on you and not on the things of this world that will soon pass away. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today's encouragement was provided by Our Daily Bread Ministries.